We work to promote and defend women's rights, but it's not easy because the war is still going on. And when militia come in the city or the village, they rape again women. Even if they stand up and they beginning to do some activities, when the militia come or FRDC, the Congolese army come in the village to fight the group army, they rape women, they kill people, and it's not easy. When we need that community, international community to help to restore peace in DRC, we can change really the situation and stop rape in DRC. Another challenge is peace process. We agree that international community, UN, accompany DRC to try to restore peace, but it's not enough. Sometimes we don't understand why. It takes more time. That is the very big challenge we have, and we need support, financial support. I go to the different meeting, the high level meeting. People say we need to support grassroots to change the situation of women. They have this the objective. They say for 2030, they say we need to support, but they don't change the policy because all government don't accept to give money to small group in the grassroots. They only give to the NGO, international NGO, to do the job. That in my country, people understand that finally it's a business because they cannot change our situation, really. We are the one who know the causes. We are the one who can change. We have the solution. And we are the one who can speak to the leaders, traditional leaders, to change our situation. But if they don't accept to support this work, we cannot get a solution and be able to attend these objectives.
I cannot describe what was happening within the impact of the in the East Congo on the population. And she's taking care of them, her organization. African women are resilient. If they were not doing, if she was not there, I think you will never heard some young boys and girls being back at school. And this is what, it's a drop in the ocean. But that drop, you know, can be multiplied if we support the women of Africa.